looks okay now. Ooh. Bony. We go over here. This farm is maybe not quite as clean as I am used to. even the clean stuff. I might not let this get on me too much. off the spiky rock over there. Oh, I went too far over there. So it was a fun bit to go back with you. Getting a bit low. Work out both sets of muscles. How's it going?
Woo-hoo.
Can you tell me, is the red light flashing on the front of the camera? Flashing, flashing? Cool, thanks. Okay, go, 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 go. Oh, you're too late. Oh, sorry. Bad timing. The rock in front of you. Oh. The first test of the day. First test of the day. Oh, cool. Feel good? Oh, cool. Rush hour for the planes and the trains. Mine jets, yeah, 717s. And Bombardiers. Thank you. it through the middle the easiest. Well, you can go left and right as well, but middle is easiest too. Are you recording as well? Oh yeah. Yeah, it's a little bit lower than I wanted. It'll be fine, but only just. Gotta be careful of things like that log there. That stick in the water. Yeah, come and paddle the wave hopper with us on flat water, and then you'll start getting a feel for it. And then maybe after this year's descent, start paddling it in moving water, or we'll start just come with me whenever, wherever, because you'll find it's very forgiving, and it probably turns more than that boat does. So you got to get used to it being even more bouncy off sides, you know. But I mean. I don't think it took me very long, and I mean, if you're used to, like, that's why I say it's like the interceptor, because you always have to be turning the interceptor. From what I remember, the two paddles that I had in it, it doesn't go straight. Like, even by default, if you lean it upright and have it in the middle, it still doesn't go straight. So you had to lean one way or the other, or be turning one way or the other, and then obviously the currents and the wind. So it's the same in this boat, that you're always just adjusting, and everything is always a turning motion. But after a few years, I didn't need to think about it anymore, and now it goes straighter than anything else would go. Yeah, and because of its turning ability, you can just think of where you want to go, and like the S bend at the top there of sideswipe at Bell's, I can just think of what I need to do there, because I've done it for, you know, so long as well. Think of what to do. And I come into that, and the boat just does it. And I don't remember what I did to get it there, but I know it did what I wanted it to. I know now, I was focusing on it this time to actually figure out what you do. And it's like three paddle strokes, for God's sake. So But dog's breakfast, however, I messed up. I hit the rock. I went too far to the right. It's a little bit too bony for me. That rock that slices open your boat is currently looking very slice openable. So I decided I didn't want to chance it and go down on top of that, so I went to the right of it and smashed it into a big rock instead with the nose. So hopefully the nose is good. save the underside for the nose. Gonna come through the tea trees with me in the middle. Oh, left hand side, yeah. You got a log to jump at the top, but then you should be okay. If you come the middle, you can go middle left. You can head across there. I don't know what noise you guys make when bills. Another mine plane. Thank you. in that gravel. Do you think there's grass here naturally? No, do you think the grass was here before colonization? I'm wondering how much of this is the original, like, what it would be like. Yeah, there would have been more tea trees in the river, I guess. Maybe not, because the floods would have flooded them out every year. Yeah, this is where all the huge logs that fell over during the storms have come down to, I guess. Remember during the huge floods, 2016, whenever the really big one happened, down here there was just piles and piles and piles of this sort of stuff. Yeah, yeah. And then at Upper Swan Bridge, it was piled high on the bridge, and when we came through, it was about a meter above you, and you went through a little tunnel. I felt like any moment it would collapse and trap you. So huge logs. Yeah. Yeah. Well, the bridge itself is made of wood, so don't know if it's any better or worse. Yeah. Boat feels great, but I am not fit. Well, I think it's fine though. You don't need to be fit to paddle long distances. You just need to have lots of energy in you and not get injured. So if you're doing something that injures you, then yeah, you need to practice and not do it. But if you're able to just go on and on, my wrist has always been a problem, but I just need to remember. It's hilarious. I need to remember to do this with my left hand, and then my right wrist doesn't get as bad. But Indy says, oh, that gives you that's really bad. You should never do that with your wrist. So, well, that's how I prevent it in the other hand. So, you know, he says, oh, you'll get RSI in the hand that you're doing it in. Well, my left hand isn't a problem. It's the right hand that's the problem. Yeah, I wonder if there'll be any blockages down here. I was going to go down Nev's channel, but now I want to see if there are any blockages in the Amazon, but I suppose I'll go Nev's. I never go Nev's channel, and I'd like to see it today. The wizard tree. That'll get you in high water, geez. yeah, geez, definitely right in that one today. There used to be a gap cut through the logs on the right, but I think the left-hand side is easier now. Yeah, yeah. Used to be another tree over here, I think, which looks like it might have sunk, or Yeah, see, they cut off the branch there, so there's been a bit of human help there. Well, that's where you used to walk, wasn't it? Remember when the tree blocked here, and when it got low, you had to portage the little short distance. Oh no, that was out down at the bridge. Yeah. Further still. Okay. Oh. Yep. I imagine you still could, but where did that branch off? Above it. Yeah. Oh, first pelican. Yeah. Hey, buddy. Almost hit that tree, didn't ya? Smashed into that tree and kept flying. You see the top guys with a tube hanging outside their boat, and I always thought it was because they've let go their drink straw, but it's a Venturi thing. Yeah, do you think that would work if I just had one from the back hole in the back of the boat? Yeah, it's worth a try. I'm swimming in water right now, so anything to get rid of all of this, please. Yeah, I'd have to stop every hour at this rate. Extra stops. There's tons of gravel close to the surface. Well, grass is here, but gravel further up. I was thinking of panning for gold in here. Do you reckon there'd be any? I'm sure the blackfellas would be very happy. Yeah. Just to do one at a time. Watch out for whatever that was.
Hi.
That's my bank. That's where the power boat jumped over my boat. Not enough water, hey? That's Steve's folly, yeah? Yeah. Not a mine jet. Well, different one. Sorry? Isn't that Steve's folly? Okay, yeah. It's all really flooded out since then. Like, there was a gap about the size of a boat, of a canoe, that year. Now most of the water goes through the gap now. Because there's been at least two iterations since we had our run, I guess, where it was filled up with sand from about 2016 to 2020. It was filled up with sand and you couldn't even go half of those channels from the first flood. And then in about 2020, the next flood opened them all up again, and then you could start going there again, but they were different. And now this next flood has modified them again so that they're open now, so you can see them. But wow, they're different to, you go in there and oh, that's right, it's not nearly as high as it used to be, or there's a tree in the way, or oh, something else. But in general, it's got easier where the channel that wasn't open is now open, or the tree in the way is now gone, or the channel is deeper than it was before because it's been scoured out by the floods. So most, we'll see it. That's why I want to go Ned's channel to see whether all those sandbars are higher or lower than before. Because it's about 0.5, I reckon. I should have looked at the gauge, but it's about 0.5. Ah! Getting some tea trees training in. Involuntary tea trees training. Here we are at the bridges. A bit of a tuft of grass there, yeah. Well, I tell you, straight I don't think is the way. Oh. Yeah, okay. That's cool. Might be some obstacles. Pretty good both ways, I think. It's good. That's where the channel branches off. See that channel there? That's the shortcut. Yeah. So the one in front of us is a dead end, and you're gonna go further left. You can go up that one and then turn further left. First one's open. And it's the direct route to it. The other one, you've got to cut through another line of... Because there's island, and then another island, and then another island. You know, like, all of these are just little, like, slivers. Well, that's why you need to be the other side of the fence. So you want to get the other side of the fence as soon as possible, because that fence comes out of the water and starts to become an actual fence again. Well, no. The whole point is that down here is where the flow is, and where it's ripping through fast is here. Up there, there's no flow. It's all really soft. But watch that video again of me going through the footbridge up there. I like grabbed the bits of the footbridge and I thought to myself, wow, if the flow was any greater, this would be a problem. Yeah. Because it was more dangerous, but it's a more dangerous area, but safer because of the flow. Jeez, look at all this debris. Wasn't as much on the Upper Swan Bridge as there was the other year, though. A little bit, but not a lot. But geez, you can see how high it's been. I mean, I think it was 2.5. And that was months ago. Oop, I know. Yeah. Alright, I don't go straight. It's just me. There's our old channel. This is where the fanfare, where we got stuck in the fanfare that one time. And the S bend, you're gonna do the S bend. Oops, sorry. my bad. I didn't go fast enough. Actually, that wasn't right here. It was a little bit further, wasn't it? Yeah. Yeah, this is not easy over here. There's proper tea tree stuff. Yeah, nice. Any higher and you'd be stuck there. Can only just duck under there without hitting it. Oh, yeah, either way. Maybe this one was the fanfare channel. I think we grounded out here because we couldn't make the turn to the right there. Maybe? I don't know. Seems deeper. Thank you. Now we're at Nebs. Thought that couldn't be it back there, but no, it wasn't. You coming down Nebs as well? Cool, cool. That can be Nibs fully now. So pretty deep. I'd say pretty deep. I'd say pretty much the way to go. Different, and I know, still live shallow, which I am not familiar with since about 2018. Sterling's tree. Still alive. Nice. Hooray! Thank you. looks like the spot.